Hi, it's me, Wild Horse from Move Route, and today I'm out on my bike in the fields, just riding across the fields, enjoying the sun and freeing my mind from anything I don't want in it. And I've just been thinking lately, because I am out ever so much barefoot at the moment. You can see I've even got brown feet because I've been out barefoot so much, and it's about the best time of the year for barefoot walking as well and running. But of course, if you're used to walking in shoes all your life and you've never had to bother about stepping carefully, but you're just used to falling onto the next step, falling onto your heel and sticking your leg far out, you might have some problems getting the stability and the balance for a good soft barefoot walking. Now, when you go barefoot walking, you will learn to walk in a slightly different manner. Barefoot walking doesn't just mean taking your shoes off and falling into your next step, falling onto your heel as you were used to. It means stepping more carefully. So you need a lot of core stability and a lot of balance. And also barefoot walking will give you a lot of core stability and a lot of balance. Funny, isn't it? Now, look, when I walk barefoot, I don't fall onto my heel like that, right? I step. Look, I have control over my step, really, until the last moment. Of course, I don't walk like that all the time. You know, I walk more fluent than that. See? My weight is more in my center. I don't fall into my next step. I put my foot down, and I don't stomp on my heel. I put my foot down with the outer side of the forefoot first, and then I roll down onto my heel. So this way there's no great pressure on my back, on my joints, and my body stabilizes in a totally different manner all the time. So of course it's always good to do core training, and it's always important to get your core and your back straight and in balance and strong. But one thing that's going to help you barefoot walking, because you are using your tendons in a different way and your muscles and all that, to keep your hips and your back open and in alignment, is just to practice the squat regularly. Now, it's something really easy to do, but how many of us do it every day? You should do squats every day, and this squatting will just help open and align your hip and your back, and this will give you a good basic to go out barefoot walking. And apart from that, I'll just show you a few exercises for your feet so that you can train your feet and get accustomed to balance and barefoot walking. Here goes. Wild Horse for Move Route. Get outside and move to your roots.